Here's a little tool I dreamed up for measuring water pressure around the house to find out where I've got good water pressure and not good water pressure, but I put a little twist to it. Let me show you that. To make a pressure gauge isn't very hard. All you need is a pressure gauge and some way to attach it. And pressure is interesting, especially if you have a multi-story house. But let me show you something else that's even more interesting, is this little valve back here. I can measure the dynamic pressure at different locations, and it doesn't have any absolute meaning, but compared to other things, it can tell you a lot of information. Let me show you that. Let's see what it looks like with the valve open here. Looks like about 21, stabilizing about 21. It's hard to see, it's awfully bright out here. And when I turn on the opening in the back and look at the dynamic pressure, it drops down to about, call it 18, 19. So that tells me, it gives me an idea of the friction on the pipe. Let's go look at some others. Here's another faucet at the back of the house, and it's also like 21, a little bit, 21 and a half. So let's open it up and see what happens. It only drops down to 20. Doesn't have as much loss as the one in the front of the house. So this is a valve up a story higher. We'll call it 17 and a half, something like that. See what happens when we open the dynamic, get the dynamic pressure on it. And it drops down to 15, 15 and a half, somewhere in that range. Let's see what this one does. This is from a 2-inch line that comes directly from the city. And we'll see how much it varies when we open the pressure. And it went from 10 to stabilizing about 9. So not unexpected. Let's go over how I made this. I got a gauge, and in this case this gauge goes from 0 to 40 psi, or 0 to 3 kilograms per square centimeter. And you need to get whatever's applicable to your area. I've lived in houses that are closer to 80 psi. So, but this one's adequate. Then I needed an adapter to more of a half-inch size, half-inch standard plumbing size. And my hardware store didn't have one, so I made one. My guess is yours would probably have one, but anyway, just an adapter from here to this is a half-inch an adapter. And it was using a water filter. You can see where the water filter came out, and it was just that little piece between the wall and the sink, or wherever you're tapping from. So that was it, just a water filter tap. And then this tubing, as you may probably recognize it, comes out and goes to, it's used in, to connect the wall to the toilet or wall to the sink or whatever like that. And so I can use this piece right here to connect to sinks or toilet taps or whatever, could check pressure there. And then I've got a plumbing spear. I got a steel one here. Normally I'd use brass or stainless, but this one is not going to be wet very long for very often. So steel is adequate. Then the last thing is the tube, and the tube I can clamp onto faucets or whatever that do not have a screw type adapter or whatever. So I can just clamp those over the end of a faucet. And then the last thing is the adapter for like your garden hose or whatever, so whatever style you use. And so I can pretty much cover my whole house using this setup and measure the pressure just about everywhere in the house. So whatever you need to do, I mean, you need to come up with something equivalent. But that's it. That's how it's made, and to show you how it's operated, just connect it, measure the static pressure, and then measure the dynamic pressure. The hole here is roughly half of this tube right here, so I'm getting about half the flow, and I'm checking the drop at about half of the water level. So what is the difference between the static pressure and dynamic pressure? What does that tell us? Well, in one case, I found I had 15 of these in a very short distance, and it was killing the water pressure. I understand that these increase friction by about 1.5, 1.7% each. So 10 of them is like 17% loss in your pressure, your flow. So that's pretty significant. Another case, this one's not as bad as another one I found. I threw the other one away, but you can see that it starts to get blocked up. And yeah, you can find things like this. So one bathroom is okay, another one is not. The pressure is the same in both, but as soon as you open the dynamic pressure, measure the dynamic pressure, you find out which ones are starting to block up. Here we are at the washing machine and getting adequate pressure, but the pressure underflow is very poor. I'm suspecting it is this valve. This valve probably has a very tiny opening through it. At least I'm hoping that's what it is. That'll be the easiest thing to fix. But help me locate this. And this tangle of pipes leads downstairs. There's two bathrooms, one to my left and one to my right. And we're having terrible problems with the one on my right. The one on the left was okay, and they're both operating from the same supply line. It turns out that, and we'd missed it the first time, back in this tangle, I don't know if you can see it, back here where my finger is, there is, there was a steel pipe nipple that was rusted, almost entirely closed, so it helped us locate where this issue was. This is an inexpensive tool that gives you some valuable information on things around your house, what's blocking up, whether you've got some poor work in the past. It'll help you track down bad valves, whatever. But bottom line, that's what it's there for, is to provide valuable information, allow you to compare between different areas in your house. I hope you found this interesting and useful in your future plumbing projects.